Right. So in this video, we are going to make an introduction to Rhino, and in this video, we are going to see how we can navigate inside the viewport. Basically, if you open the Rhino for the first time, I'm using the Rhino 5. Now there is Rhino 6, but the similarity isn't a big difference. So let's see how we can navigate. Basically, you will see this perspective view, and you will see four orthographic top and front and right. You can left click two time in each of these to maximize, such as this. So we are now here in the front, and if you are in the perspective, and let's say that you have any geometry such as this, and here you can change the viewport mode. So this is shaded, and this is X-ray, and this is also an artistic. So the viewport is differ from these icons, and here is the navigation or the navigation buttons. So let's explain that in a moment. So you can use a right click to navigate around your model like this, and you can ban using shift and right click. So we are banning left and right like this. So right click to rotate, and shift right click to ban this item, and you can zoom in using the mouse wheel. But if you don't have the mouse wheel, you can control and right click to zoom in and zoom out. And here is the tip and the trick. If you used the control and right click and left and right, you can zoom in and zoom out slightly, and up and down to zoom in fast and zoom out fast. So that was the first item in our lesson on how you can navigate in Rhino. So let's see what we have. I will go from my perspective and going to the top. Let's see what we have here. So you can cancel from here. You cancel all right click. Here is an tip. If you hover in any of icon of this, you will see that the left click doing something and the right click doing some other thing. So here is also the command line, and here is some panels. You can go from panel to hide any of these panels or add any also another panel. So if I say that I want to add the notes, this is the notes, and you can stuck it to be here or here, and you can hide all of these from panels also. You can hide the notes such as this, and here is the command line. You can write, for example, line, and it will type here, and you are now making a line. And here is some panels and some icons, but these are the standard, and you will see how we can draw a polyline. So drawing a polyline such as this, and polyline is differs from the line because the polyline is a continuous line which is an one piece, and you can use explode to destroy it and convert the polyline to an line. We will cover that later, but let's explain something. So I will delete all this using delete, and using, if you are in the orthographic such as top or front, you can using only the right click to ban. No, you don't need to use the shift and right click. You can also use only the right click. So let's draw a curve such as this. So we have some curve here, and click enter to approve that you will end here. And if you have curve, you have something here which is points on and points off. So each curve, if you have an experience of Illustrator, you will see that this curve is very, very similar to the bin tool in Illustrator or Photoshop. So you can use the point on to modify some of these curves. So select this, and you can modify any of these, or you can, if you you want to submit this, you can press F11, or you can delete any of these vertex if you don't need, if you see that you have a lot of vertex of or a lot of points on this curve, you can delete only any of these points. And you can also right click to hide these points. And as you can see, one curve point added and points off. And you will see you can track your last commands here. If you you can see that all of your commands here has been shown. So that's concluded for this video. I hope you enjoy this first lesson. See you in the next lesson, which is the second lesson in an introduction for Rhino.